Welcome to the Turku University Libraries tutorial on how to search PubMed efficiently. In this video, we will show you how to create a search string containing both your own keywords and controlled vocabulary subject headings. To start the search, we've chosen the research topic, which is, what's the connection between sunburned skin and women's skin cancer? That means our keywords are sunburned skin, skin cancer, and women. We've listed the keywords we found from dictionaries and through initial searches in a text file. We recommend using PubMed through our library's homepage. Scroll down to find the right resources menu, select any of the guides for medicine, and choose the database link from the guide. Navigating through these steps makes it easier to later check the full text availability of our university. And now we'll open PubMed on two tabs in the browser. In the first tab, we'll create a search string with our own keywords. We'll open the advanced search and use the query box, where we'll write the keywords for sunburn and UV radiation connected with Boolean OR operators in parentheses. We'll add the first AND operator and add all the keywords for skin cancer in another pair of parentheses. Then we'll add another AND operator and add the last set of keywords for women in parentheses. There are a few features of PubMed to be aware of. When using phrases with two or more words, they should be placed in quotation marks in the search string with the last word truncated with an asterisk. Another thing is that most of the articles are indexed or tagged with MeSH subject headings. With MeSH terms, you can easily find articles dealing with a given subject. Keep in mind, though, that the newest articles are not indexed immediately. We'll now move on to the MeSH database by clicking the link on PubMed's homepage in the other tab. A controlled vocabulary thesaurus like MeSH is like a monolingual dictionary where you can check the right words to be used to find material in a database. If needed, you can also truncate MeSH terms with an asterisk. First, we'll search for the MeSH term for sunburn. Search for one word at a time and try to search with all of its synonyms. Choose the MeSH term closest to your search and move it to the search builder by clicking the Add to Search Builder button on the right-hand side of the page. Copy and paste the term from the box to the correct OR clause in the search string in the other tab. Now we'll look for the MeSH term for skin cancer and move it to the search string. And finally, we'll find out which term is used for women and add that as well. Now that we've combined the MeSH terms with our own keywords, our search string is complete. By adding MeSH terms into the search string, you can find references that a simple keyword search might not catch. After searching, you can narrow down the search results by adding filters from the left-hand menu. To filter the results by language, select Additional Filters, then select Language, choose the ones you need, and click on Show. This will transfer the language limits to the menu. Select them to activate the filters. Another good filter is time range. Please be aware that the publication date ranges are not fixed time frames. which means a 10-year range today is different from tomorrow's by a day from both ends. To get a fixed range, choose the time range from the results by year slider at the top of the menu. Please note that most of the other filters work based on added metadata, like mesh terms. Using them will cause you to filter out the newest articles from the search results. You should also note that PubMed saves the filters you've chosen. So remember to edit them if necessary or remove them by selecting Clear All. Another filter you should avoid using is the text availability filters, full text or free full text, because PubMed doesn't recognize which journals are available for us at the University of Turku. When you access PubMed via the library's homepage through the library guides, you can check the full text availability by using the library's Vault That link in the references. It's on the right-hand side of the page after you open the search result. The appearance of the link here has changed to a more recognizable one in 2020. Apologies for the old footage. Lastly, I want to remind you to always remember to save your search string for later use in a text file or by creating a user account in the database. If you have any questions about information seeking, please contact us at library@utu.fi.